Morning, YouTubers. Sunday, January, whatever. Skip 20 here, down here in Knoxville, Tennessee. Believe it or not, I actually finished my Subaru cutaway engine. I made a Subaru sign showing the person that did a beautiful, excellent job of designing this and putting it on Thingiverse for free. This thing is nicely detailed and prints very nicely. I also have another one, which was my screw-ups. I picked up some cheap filament, which was rejects actually, and it turned out to be gray in the beginning, and I printed the heads and I printed the engine, and my printer stopped right there. So I had so many parts laying around, I went ahead and sunk the engine below the bed and printed the rest of it. Now this one is glued together. The belt's glued on. Intake does come off. Does have a flywheel. Valve covers do not come off. Nothing comes off. But this one is actually finished. You notice I took the throttle body from his Toyota engine, resized it, printed a wedge for it. It actually has a throttle. Works. There is still one small problem with this, and I just found out what it is. See the top of the engine jumping? Manifold comes off. Cover comes off. You see the valves moving. I think I still need to do some valve timing on this. But underneath here, there's a piece of plastic that sort of sticks out and is rubbing on it. So I need to grind that down a little bit, and everything should be fine and dandy. Valve covers come off. See the valves working? The cam's working. Anything on this side? Has a motor inside the oil pan operating the flywheel. Look at the detail on this thing though. This thing is beautiful. I'm building 3 kit cars and I threw away all the Volkswagens and put in Subarus. 2 of them have Subaru 6 cylinders, a 3.3 and a 3.0. The other one has a 2.2, and I'm building a Frankenstein flatbed truck with a 70 Volkswagen Subaru pusher, which has a 2.5 Subaru automatic sitting in it. It looks like the pistons are still hitting the head. Whoop, there it goes. It broke. He's hitting the valves. So, rod covers go on with magnets. Rod cover goes back on. Oop, wrong way. And the intake goes on. This is a cool project. It took time. Here's my speed right here. These little babies can crank. But I do plan on making an air conditioner which fits over here. This intake manifold actually is supposed to mount this way. Subaru has an air conditioner here. The alternator here, the power steering pump over here. Here. I'm sorry, my finger's getting screwed up. So I resized the pulley from the Toyota and mounted it, the crankshaft pulley, mounted it to the crank. It'd be belt driven to think different parts. I can remove the belt to remove the top of the engine. Yeah, it looks like I need to repair a piston. Looks like it came disconnected from the rod. But this was an enjoyable project. Hair raising at times. Here's a bag of goodies. Additional parts printed. Making changes along the way. So here are my two Subaru cutaway engines. Thanks for watching. This is available on Thingiverse by Eric the Pool Boy. I don't think he's much of a boy, but I guess he works on pools. But he is good. Can even see the EJ20, except this camera won't focus. So have a good New Year's. It's about the 7th or whatever it is. I may or may not do the Toyota engine. He has a complete four-wheel drive transmission with transfer case and all. I did see a video where he was at a show and he had the Subaru transmission, but he's never posted it. And I sure would like that on this engine. So take care, have fun, enjoy 3D printing this year. Prices have been coming down. I've been doing this since the Maker Farm came out 5, 6, 7 years ago, I don't know. That was actually a modified of a Maker Farm with a new box underneath it. And he's in cold storage. I have the new Tornado, which I love. I've had a couple of headaches with it, but it works beautifully when it does work. I also have a Wahoo, which I've had to change the build plate on it. I got one of these GeckoTech stick-on plates. It seems to stick pretty good with that, and pretty easy to take them off. That's about it. There's my 3D printed Subaru cutaway engine. Sayonara.